Welcome to this new video where we'll solve a challenging coding problem, the decode string problem. We have an encoded string s and we want to decode it. The encoding rule is a positive integer k followed by an encoded string between brackets that has to be repeated k times in the final output. For example, if we have ac3 bracket ab bracket d, ab has to be repeated 3 times in the decoded string. We get ac ab 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 d. Assume that the input string is always valid, so we can't find things like this for example. This problem would have been easy if there was no nested encoded strings, like in this one. We just have to search for integers k and multiply the string that comes after each one of them. But the problem is that we can have nested encoded strings, like in this one. 3 bracket a2 bracket c bracket bracket. To decode this one, we first need to decode the inner string, we get acc, then we can decode the outer string, we get acc, acc, acc. And there is no limit for the depth of our encoded string, so we can have something like this as input. A first possible solution is to use recursion, because to decode an expression, we first need to decode its sub-expressions. With this input, we read a, b, a, then we find an integer. It means that we have an encoded string, the one between brackets. We find where it ends and we call the function to decode it. We read c, then we find an integer. This inner expression also has an expression inside it. We call the function again. We read e, d, and the expression ends. Now we decoded the inner expression, we repeat it 3 times because the integer before it is 3. We get ed, ed, ed. We finish decoding this expression, we return it, and we repeat it twice. Now we went back to the initial expression, we can continue. We read a, c, we find another expression, and the same process will happen. I'll just let the animation continue the work. And we got the decoded string, we return it. The problem with the solution is that it's quite slow, because before being able to recursively call the function, we first need to find the end of the inner encoded string. And because of that, we may traverse the whole string. So in the worst case, we traverse n characters to decode the initial string, n-3 characters for the inner one, then n-6, n-9, and so on. Even if the size is decreasing, but we still get off n squared time complexity because the sum of n-3 times k, where k goes from 0 to n divided by 3 is this one, which gives off n squared. Note that we assume that integers inside the encoded string don't exceed a certain constant. This is why we counted the cost of the action of repeating the decoded string as O of n. The second solution is to use regular expressions. The idea is that while we still have encoded strings, we search for substrings of type integer, then opening bracket, then alphabetical letters, then closing bracket, and we replace them by the integer multiplied by the string between brackets. With the previous input, at the first iteration, here are the parts that match our description. 3ED gets replaced by ED, 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 3B becomes BBB, and 4CD becomes CD, 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 CD. Second iteration, 2CED, ED, ED is replaced by 2 times CED, ED, ED, and 2BBB is replaced by 2 times BBB. We still have encoded strings, so we keep iterating. And this is what happens in the third iteration, we replace 2BBBBBBC. We have no more encoded string, so we finished, we decode the initial input. And the regular expression we use to find substrings that match our description is this one. I know that it's scary if you don't know regular expressions, but let me break it down to you into 4 parts. The first one is 09+, it means 1 or more digit, because we want it to start by an integer, and an integer may have multiple digits. Then we have escape character then opening bracket, it means that it needs to find an opening bracket. Then we have az+, it means 1 or more alphabetical letter. And last one, escape character then closing bracket, it means that it needs to find a closing bracket. So this regular expression matches strings that have 1 or more digit, then an opening bracket, then 1 or more alphabetical letter, then a closing bracket. But the solution is also slow, because at each iteration, we need to traverse the whole string to find substrings that match the regular expression, then replace them. We get an off n squared time complexity. Now we can move to the optimized solution, but before, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. In the third solution, we will use the stack data structure. Let's briefly talk about why stack and not another data structure. Let's suppose that we want to decode this string. We read a, b, a, then we find an integer. It means that we need to multiply it by the expression that comes after it. But the problem is that we didn't decode it yet. So what we're gonna do is that we will store the part we decoded until now and the integer in a stack, such that when we finish decoding the inner expression, we pop them back and we can multiply. Okay, so let's decode this inner expression. We have c, then we find an integer again. Same thing, we store the part we decoded and the integer in the stack. We read e, we read d, and we find a closing bracket, so we can't pop from the stack. The decoded string becomes the string we popped from the stack, plus the integer times the decoded string. We did that because finding a closing bracket means that we finished decoding an expression, so we can multiply it by the integer that we found in the level before it. After it, we find another closing bracket. We do the same thing, we pop, and the decoded string becomes the popped string plus the popped integer times the decoded string. And we finish decoding the input. We use the stack because the expression of the first level has to be decoded at the end, so the first tuple that enters the structure has to be the last one to be retrieved, and it perfectly fits the logic of the stack. The stack is based on the fill-all principle, first in, last out. The first data that is pushed onto the stack is the last one that gets popped, and it's exactly what we want. For the algorithm, we need a stack, a string where we will store our decoded string, and an integer count to store the integer that we find. But note that we will use an array instead of a string for decoded, because adding characters to a string creates a whole new string because strings are immutable in Python, so it slows down the process. This is why we will use an array, then we'll join characters at the end. Now, while traversing the string, we have four cases. The case where the character is a letter, the case where it's a digit, the case where it's an opening bracket, and the case where it's a closing bracket. And we need to understand what happens in each case. When it's a letter, we just add it to our decoded string. When it's a number, we have to insert it into the integer count, for that we multiply count by 10 and we add a digit. For example, if we have 254 in the string, it will be read digit by digit. We will have 0, then 2, then 25, then 254. And when it's an opening bracket, it means that we will start decoding an expression. So we insert in the stack the part we decoded and the integer we found now, and we empty them to start decoding a new expression. And when we find the closing bracket, it means that we finish decoding the actual expression. We can't multiply it by the integer of the expression where it belongs. This is why we pop from the stack, and decoded becomes the string we popped plus the integer we popped times decoded. In Python, we can repeat a string by using the asterisk operator. You'll better understand this part in the example we'll see later, but in Brief, it's like we went back to the previous level and took the data we stored for that level, because each tuple in the stack represents one level of depth. After the loop, we join the characters and return the decoded string. Now that we know how does the algorithm work, let's apply it on the example we're working with in this video. We have our stack, our decoded string, our integer count, so we can start. First character, it's a letter, we just added to decoded. Next character, also a letter, we add. Next character, same thing. Next character, it's a number, count becomes 2. Next character, an opening bracket, here we store count and decoded in the stack and we empty them. Next character, a letter, we add it to decoded. Next character, a number, count becomes 3. Next character, an opening bracket, we store in the stack and we empty count and decoded. Next character, a letter, we add it to decoded. Next character, same thing. Next character, a closing bracket, here we pop from the stack the previous count and decoded becomes previous decoded plus previous count times the actual decoded. In our case, it becomes c plus 3 times ed. Next character, same thing, closing bracket. Previous count is 2, previous decoded is aba, and actual decoded is cededed. So decoded becomes aba plus 2 times cededed. What we did here is that, once we finish decoding C3 bracket ED bracket, we wanted to go back to the previous level in the expression, so we took the data we stored before to be able to continue. This is why we multiply the decoded expression between brackets by the integer we stored. And now we'll just let the animation continue the work. We finished traversing the string by applying the algorithm, and we got our decoded string. The time complexity of this solution is of n, where n is the length of the input string, we're traversing the string once. But we can have cases where it takes way more than n operations because of the integers inside the encoded string that will make it way longer. Before ending this video, I wanted to mention something interesting, is that the recursive solution and the stack-based solution are closely related. You need to know that the recursive process uses a stack to handle the different active recursive calls. It's named the call stack. Every time there is a new recursive call, a new stack frame appears on the call stack, and when it ends, that stack frame disappears and the program goes back to the one that called it. And it's basically what we did in the stack-based solution. Every time we found an inner encoded string, we create a new stack frame, we decode the actual string, and we pop to go back to the previous level of depth. We reached the end of this video. I hope that you understood all the three solutions, and see you in the next one.